Hi, I'm Steve Oliver. My wife and I are the Oregon Aero Sky Dancer and Sky Rider. We were with Pepsi 25 years, the longest sponsored act in the air show industry. Behind me is the Oregon Aero Sky Dancer, a modified de Havilland Chipmunk, first built in 1953, but 2-year total rebuild in 1989. This is the 23rd year on the air show circuit, and my wife and I are celebrating our 30th year of working together in the air show industry. She's the Sky Rider, I'm the Sky Dancer. What we refer to as smoke that you see all air show performers and Sky Riders, of which there's only a couple, and the Sky Typers, is not smoke, it's actually visible vapor. It's a lightweight paraffinic based fluid that's injected into the exhaust pipe where it expands 50,000 to one. And because of it being paraffinic based, it becomes white from the vaporization, we like to say. It's actually visible moisture. So it's injected into the exhaust pipe here with an electric pump at the rate on our airplane of about 1.25 gallons per minute. It's going in there twice as fast as the gasoline that I'm putting into a 380 horsepower homing, and then it comes out the exhaust. The sky riding itself is not computer controlled. It's seat of the pants, and you have to know, we say this, the dance. You have to know the path of the airplane that it flies. The first sky riding was done in America in 1922. We do it exactly the same way that they did it back then. An interesting point is that it is done mirror image. If you can imagine, let's take the letter S. If I wanted to make an S for you, or normally my wife would, who's the sky rider, though she taught me how to sky ride, and occasionally I fill in. But if I take that S and put it up above you, we're on the back side of it. So we're riding basically right to left, and every letter is reversed. So we call it mirror image. Now, the hardest part about sky riding is the level of precision it takes, because you have to be absolutely correct, dead on headings and altitudes and rates of turn. So if you were going to teach somebody to skyride, the first thing you'd have to do is teach them to fly very, very precise. With that being said, I could take somebody who is a precise flyer, like an air show performer or a crop duster or a person that flies the camera ships where they have to hold exact altitudes and headings, or if their personal flying habits are very precise, I could teach them the dance, as we call it, the routine, and they could go up and skyride the first time, which is what I did. My first skywriting ever was done over the Daytona 500 with, what, 500,000 people look at me, and I skyrode Pepsi. My wife taught me, and what we did is we sat on the ground, and I memorized the thing, and I could pair it back to her. I'm going to go so many seconds this way in a certain kind of turn, and on, smoke off, and stuff. And we literally walked it through on the ground, just like you write your name in the snow or something, or in the sand at the beach. And so when I did that, she said, okay, you've got it, go do it. And I took off and went and flew. And it probably was as good a sign as I've ever done. My personal flying habits have always been precise, because I have been a crop duster and all that other kind of stuff, but that's just the way I flew. So the learning curve for me wasn't that great. Also, with that being said, 30 years, there's still little tricks that we're learning every now and then. So it's experience more than anything. Suzanne is the only person that's made her entire living in her adult life as a skywriter in the entire world.